Sometimes life feels a bit opaque, and words they sound like threats. Well, I tried and I failed. At least I did.
It all started with a deep feeling of longing, of wanting to belong. Just by admiring one single rose, the song came to be. An author once said, "The truly creative mind in any field is no more than this, a human creature born abnormally, inhumanly sensitive." This is a story about one such creature, although I should stop calling her a creature because she's something more rare than that. She's a struggling artist of the 21st century. The very first step that leads to a well-written song is the recording. The first recording or demo doesn't have to be perfect, but the equipment should work for it to happen. After struggling for some time, she manages to secure the mic stand with a hairband. How peculiar of her. But drastic times sure call for drastic measures. Some call it thinking outside the box, while others call it being cuckoo. If being cuckoo means being resourceful, then she is indeed that. Artists have naturally taken on the role of jack of all trades ever since they were little. No one knows if it's given to them by birth, or if they inherited it through life's struggles. But one thing is for certain, they will do anything possible and impossible to mend your heart and put all the broken pieces back together. With just one line in a song that stings and heals in tandem, or a heartfelt melody that brings back a once forgotten memory. Most of them are aware that they will forever give more than they will receive. It's a conscious act of selflessness done for a better tomorrow. Even though people are aware of their sensitive nature, they taught them that only a few chosen ones will be granted an artist's title. So every choice they make can make or break what they have been building their whole lives. Working alone is hard, but trusting people is even harder. Our protagonist has not been a stranger to that feeling. So she decided to take matters into her own hands. For these kinds of people, ideas come around every second of the time. The most important thing for them is to not cut the string of thought. Contrary to everyone's belief, they are not lazy. They spend every day of their lives either working on their ideas or waiting for them to happen. They actually have a driving force of an African bush elephant. However, due to their often quiet demeanor, they are usually perceived as ill-equipped. A minority of them are lucky to have someone who supports and loves them unconditionally, like our protagonist's mother does.
Here on
Devon
Music Radio.
I love you.
You're listening to the best of the latest.
While she paints, she listens to the only radio that plays her music. To a casual observer, this may look like someone simply enjoying painting. This might not be far from the truth. However, an artist is also doing a painting that will be a digital cover of her next song. Unfortunately, there are no retailers that carry the clothing for performers. Actually, there are no performers in the far-off land where she lives. So she learned how to sew and make clothes by herself. for her, clothes can furthermore enliven a performance or a music video that accompanies what matters the most, the song. Also, upcycling clothes makes her feel like she's doing something good for the planet. Unlike other human species, she doesn't dream of recognition, fame, or fortune. But her biggest fear is not being able to be truly useful to humankind. Her other fear is not being able to attain her dreams due to other various factors she can't control. Her list of incessant fears: not being able to keep a secure job for more than a year, thus not being able to pursue her creative endeavors, which automatically makes her feel like a burden. Not being able to find a working partner who won't let her down. Not being able to get on any kind of radar as a citizen of a third world country. Who even invented the algorithm, and why does it have all these restrictions? She wondered. You might wonder what keeps her sane. It's the ongoing whirlwind of imagination. A bottomless pit of thoughts and feelings occupies her daily. The only bad thing is when the art is finished, the magic stops as well. That's when the evil one appears on one of her shoulders and reassures her that there is no need for such excitement. It is only temporary. The reality check waits for you on the other side, he says. What a horrible way to spend life with someone like him. Sometimes she believes his words. But then she remembers. There is a vision that patiently waits for you to bring it alive. For example, today you'll direct and star in one of your music videos, she remembers with delight. Through her transformation as a character of Mother Nature, she will share the story of the dying importance of femininity and the unnatural division between man and woman. Nature has always been her source of inspiration, a source of solace. It has been her forever dream to bring people back to it, back to their true selves. So much of what we think we are is what we choose to be, to hide our real selves. We hide behind the titles, so our childhood wounds won't come to the surface. And And in the process of growing, we grow apart from what is true, and we become fond of what is false. If you look closer, you'll know exactly when that happened for you. But don't be frightened, the clock is still ticking, which means there is still time for you to rediscover what was once there.
Take me to the Garden of Eden.
If you paid attention, you know that I said, it happened for you, not to you. We easily get lost inside the maze that is self-pity. It becomes a safe place when there is no other. Things don't happen to you, they happen for you. They are here in your favor, no matter how challenging. Sometimes they drag you away from yourself, but that only happened so that you can remember and cherish who you really are. Just remember to take one step at a time. After a hard rain and a little persuasion that almost stopped her in her tracks, it was time for her to create another video. This time she had the help of a friend. They had an incredible 10 minutes to shoot every scene, and it was their first time doing drone filmmaking. There are always different kinds of obstacles while filming, like trying to get permission to film at a chosen location and weather changes. The most important thing for her was to make everyone feel relaxed and focused. Everything will eventually be made, but what we take home from that day is what matters the most. Every work of art is first seen by the loved ones. Somehow, our protagonist could never picture herself inside a classroom. But she enjoyed learning new skills on her own. This world of hers was more tender than the real one, so even if she didn't understand something, she would give herself time to learn. Editing, computing, softwaring. Is that even a word? She was never keen on technology, but to make her vision come true, she had to learn how to use it. Part of being an artist also means doing tedious online work and sending emails without ever receiving a response. Then one day you hear the sound of new mail. After months and months of sending emails and doing all this work, not hearing anything from anyone, she opens the email and reads, "You are irrelevant and inexperienced, and you have no following on social media. Good luck." Many people think that artists only do art. Maybe 60 years ago, when you could spend time in the south of France with Winston Churchill, who liked to paint on the grounds of your sprawling villa. Or when Vincent van Gogh was alive. But even then, during his lifetime, only one of his paintings was sold. To be an artist is to endure everyday struggles within and without. Perhaps every artist who declined to sell their soul had the adjective struggling in front of their vocation. But nothing in this world can be stronger than artists will to create. It is like mother's instinct. She fights for her children, even when they can't be useful to society. She takes care of them and loves them unconditionally. As she gathers her strength for one of her last performances, she realizes, "This has been a beautiful ride." After 20 years of building a far-reaching dream, it is time to awaken. She and music will part ways until they can create something together that can bring an impact to the world.
Soundstripe.
It is easy to give people what they want. Perhaps she didn't realize, but she was never meant to be an entertainer. An idealist who wishes to bring change, not comfort. The naturally eccentric one, who lacks the wish to be the center of attention. The down-to-earth, yet very emotional one. The one who doesn't know how to speak formally and gets frightened by business plans. There's a different kind of comfort in hearing the truth through a song, a deep feeling hiding in the pocket of your left rib. And you can only find tranquility there if you're ready to dive deep. Humans are naturally afraid of deep waters. Fear not, her inner voice said. There will come a day when you and those who share your spirit will learn how to take care of their souls. You'll realize everything inside this little world takes its course and all will follow not their will, but their hearts instead. Not my will, but the will of the one who sent me. For I have come down from heaven not to do my will, but to do the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I shall lose none of all those he has given me, but raise them up at the last day. What has chosen of you to give has no name, has no job. It's the way you smile at a stranger on a street, the way you offered to help an elderly person with their bags, the way you use your gifts to uplift those who wish the same. Be no stranger to kindness, and the rest will follow.